Google delivery.
If Google comes to me and they say, CJ, we want you to make a video endorsing Google, of course, I would love to have that conversation of creative brainstorming, but I should be ready for that moment to say, this is what I would like to do, and can I do this with you? And by the way, Google would appreciate that. The brand would always appreciate that because they'll go back and they'll be like, well, maybe we can do something different, or maybe we can do this and then do something more with this person. Or maybe it's not a good fit, but can we do something else with this person? Or, you know, CJ, we just want to do it this way. And I say to myself, well, you know, this isn't for me, but you know what? I have a network, those same friends that I copy off of, those same friends that I have these long conversations with about how all of this works here, and I can vouch for them. And please tell them that I said this so you get a lower rate, or that there's a little bit more of a intimate, personal relationship that you're developing with them.
Yeah.
So they'll give you a little bit extra.
Nice.
And that's the way you should be going into this if you're an influencer and a content creator, is that you're intentional, that you're thinking about your impact. You're not thinking about the bottom line. The bottom line will come when it's supposed to come. Your followers will come when they're supposed to come. How I gained followers, I wasn't selling anything. I wasn't promoting anything. What happened was I went through a savage breakup and I did not know how to process my emotions. And everything, it was a horror story. I'm going to write a book about this. But it was a horror story because this is what happened. We blocked, you know, you did the whole thing. You know, we blocked each other, we unfriended each other. So I did the thing where I was like, I'm just going to unfriend her. I'm not going to block her. Okay. Well, at that same time that we broke up, Instagram institutes what is now known as the algorithm. So because me and my ex-partner at the time, we took photos of each other and we used the same color grading style. Every photo of, I could see everything she was doing because the algorithm was like, this is recommended for you.
Oh my God.
So I got to see everything that she was doing during our breakup.
Wow.
Literally, this is suggested for you. This is suggested for you. This is suggested for you. And
I'm sorry too.
So I had to block her. And then we went through the whole thing of unblocking and, you know, who knows? We're together now.
Right.
We'll see everyone. We'll see how that works out. But anyway, make a long story short, I was sad. And I went on Twitter and I didn't go on YouTube. I didn't go on Vine. I didn't go on TikTok. TikTok didn't exist. I didn't go on Instagram. I went on Twitter and I made a video. And it wasn't polished, it wasn't edited, it was me walking down the street of being like, hey, if you feel this way, I just want you to know you're not alone, keep it pushing, blah, 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 blah. It went viral. So if I post something on Twitter, again, nowhere else, just on Twitter, I'll average like 10,000 views per video. And it was insane because that is literally how I grew a large following. I didn't buy anything. And then same thing with it. And then those followers migrated to Instagram, and on Instagram, it's a completely different ballgame because I am a creative. So I'm doing more creative assets there. And then I'm speaking my mind on Twitter.
Let's talk about that real quick. That leads to my next question. Responsibility. That is so when you posted that video, you gained an awareness, you created an impact.
Absolutely.
You also adopted a responsibility.
I did.
To maintain your, I know.
Yeah.
It's hard. But, so, respect, responsibility. You know, the digital space doesn't always play that back.
No.
You know, it's very destructive and it could be really hurtful. I mean, in regards to like that little algorithm by Instagram, you're seeing all your ex
like,
stuff. Like, hey, this is not a good environment for me.
Yeah.
This could create some anxiety.
Absolutely.
This could really create some depression, some areas of mental illness. I know that's something that you're going to share with us today at 2 p.m. Let's talk about that.
Sure.
Let's talk about the mental impact and the mental health obstacles that are created through the digital space.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, first of all, I think you have to understand that the digital space is exactly what it is. It's digital.
Yeah.
It's not real. So what has happened now is that it's become such an integral part of our everyday life. subconsciously. Mm-hmm. This is not a very conscious thing. We're not necessarily aware of how much of an impact it has on our lives. If we're spending too much time in this fabricated universe, mm-hmm. it's going to affect us. It's going to make us think that we're not good enough. It's going to make us feel much more lonelier than we actually are. It's going to make us look at ourselves in this very interesting way of not necessarily in an observational way, but in a judgmental way.
Yeah,
so, so we always have to make sure that, one, we are limiting our interactions with the digital landscape. Two, understand that we don't need to give it that much power. Social media specifically is a resource. That's all it is. It is not a lifestyle.
Ooh.
It is not indicative of who you are as a person.
Yeah.
It is not your character.
You're right about that.
It is a resource. That is the way it was created.
That's social. A big hurdle to get around, because not all people, you mm-hmm. know, they see it as it's their online world. It's their mm-hmm. it's their daily life. It's their lifestyle. And by not being able to create that separator, you know, mm-hmm. going that my life's here, mm-hmm. This is what I publish online as Absolutely. A reflection of it, mm-hmm. but that's not my entire scope of Correct. Who I am, of my Correct. Identity.
Correct.
And I mean, I know I've worked in the digital space and the social media world for quite some time. I've seen some pretty big, you know, media influencers hit it rock bottom, doing some really messed up stuff because of anxiety, because they're always trying to like anxiety. Be on, you know, they're always trying to maintain and be on. I have to be on all the time.
Absolutely.
You know, that
Absolutely.
Online on persona.
Absolutely. Yes.
Yeah.
And you know what? I will say, and I just thought of this when you said this, is that I come from entertainment. So I was always around celebrities, producers, executives. So my background is much more traditional in the sense that, you know, I understand what that looks like.
Yeah.
So that's what I was saying before. A lot of influencers and content creators that come into the space, they don't have that background. So they are opening themselves up. They are being vulnerable. And then they see that that's making them money.
Yeah.
So how do you turn that off?
Yeah.
Look, nobody needs to know who I'm dating. Nobody needs to know that. I don't need to put that pressure on any sort of relationship in the fact of like I'm spotlighting everything that I do. I don't need that.
Yeah.
Nobody needs to know what's going on in my family. It's none of your fucking business, to be honest with you.
Right.
Excuse my language, everybody.
It's okay. We'll edit that out.
Yeah, you can bleep me.
Bleep.
Bleep.
Take four. We're back.
And we're back.
There's some F-bombs, but we're all good now. All right. Keep going.
My whole point, not to go on a rant, but my whole point is this. Is that I believe intention is what's going to save you when it comes to what works and what doesn't work in this space. So for example, I understand Twitter is where I feel safe with discussing different views that I have. And I also understand I have a very large social responsibility, not just as a man, but as a black man, mm-hmm. as a father, as a leader amongst industries, as a voice. So I do understand that I don't get anything out of just endorsing something on Twitter. I do also understand, because this is what I do, I understand Instagram is literally a playground of ads. Right. That's literally what it is. That is business for me. That is a part of my business mm-hmm. model. So why would I be working 24 hours a day?
Good point.
Why would I do that?
Right.
It's just, if it's just business for me. And by the way, if it's just a way for me to catch up with you and see what you're up to, can I not call you and text you? Can we not meet up for coffee? Oh, wait, you live on the other side of the world. That's fine. You want to FaceTime?
Yeah.
You want to have a conversation? I don't have to compare my life to you.
Yeah.
Because if you're my friend, you're going to be my friend regardless of the situation. If you're my family, you're going to be my family regardless of the situation.
That's
if
right.
you love me, you're going to love me for me. I don't need to chase after your love.
That's good.
Right?
Yeah.
So if you are on social media and you're using it as a resource and as a tool to amplify your message, to mm-hmm. make some money, use it just that way.
Good advice.
That way.
So final question. So much good information just dropped on us. But all right. Clean slate. Imagine if you were to, knowing what you do now, like all that historical data that you've gained, if you were to enter into the social media space today, mm-hmm. what would be your first step? What would you do different mm-hmm. that otherwise you didn't do different when you were first kicking it off?
Absolutely. It's funny that you say that, because I was having this conversation just the other day with my one regret is YouTube. And the reason for that is that I'll never forget this. I got a message in my inbox, and basically YouTube was saying, hey, listen, we're creating this studio. We want you to come in, yeah. and we want you to do this, and that. We're going to help you out with this. We're going to teach you all this. And I was like, spam. And they kept sending it to me. Spam, stop sending me this. Unsubscribe. I don't want any part of this.
Yeah.
It ended up being YouTube Studio,
nice.
Which is... Wow. Literally everywhere in the world now, and they wanted to, and because they already had that information. And by the way, you didn't know that they had that information, and that information is, this is what's coming, this is what's going to happen,
right?
Same thing with Facebook. No, yeah. Like, again, we did not know that. Mm-mm. Now it's common knowledge, right. Now you can go to these, but everybody's beta testing,
yeah.
So Google understood YouTube is going to be lucrative, mm-hmm. if we teach our YouTube creators how to create the right way and give this data to them. And I missed that boat. Mm. So where I was coming from, why was I so naive about that, was that I come from the world of entertainment.
Yeah.
So I was much more focused on creating a short film and putting it on Vimeo. I was much more, you know, yes, I should do a video and tell you how to do this and that, but it needs to be polished and edited and you know, it needs to be a certain way.
Yeah.
It never occurred to me that I just put a video in front of my face. And when I finally did that, that's what changed the game.
Wow.
Man. When I finally did that.
So being a bit more, allowing yourself to be a little more raw and and transparent, you know, not trying and not, you know, we mentioned there is an element of discipline that we have mm-hmm. to maintain.
Absolutely.
You know, as it relates to responsibility, mm-hmm. as it relates to the type of content that we want to publish, if we're doing it for the right reasons,
absolutely.
You know, if we believe in our kind of our own brand, like mm-hmm. we see that, hey, we're a brand, I want to be loyal to myself, I want to be loyal to my base, etc. At the same time, though, not to be careful about hyping that up too much and allowing yourself to be more, you know, exposable, like, hey, this is just me in the world. You know,
absolutely.
I'm not always wearing makeup or dressing like this. I'm mm-hmm. just a person, mm-hmm. more relatable, more human. Yeah, I love that.
Yeah, because what I know now that I didn't know then was that I would eventually, I would eventually be able to incorporate my style and creativity anyway.
Yeah.
Like that was going to happen regardless.
Definitely.
And also, you know, it was an interesting way to start getting endorsements, because again, like you didn't really,
sure.
there wasn't, nobody was doing that. You didn't have yeah. notes to compare to. So I feel like YouTube, like I definitely missed the boat on that
yeah.
for sure. I am considered an early adopter, so it wasn't like I didn't know what was happening.
Mm-hmm.
It was just that there was nothing to compare to.
Yeah.
When you heard vlogger, you're like, oh, vlogger.
Yeah.
Same thing with Viner. And then you know, people were starting making money off of this, and you're like, oh, wait a second.
Yeah.
Things were just changing and rapidly.
Yeah, they were. Yeah. All right, final word. If you were to just lay one drop of like truth bomb on us.
Truth bomb.
Yeah, truth bomb.
Truth bomb time.
What would you leave us with something? You know, like give us, what can you give us? Just a final like going out, hey guys, do this.
Yeah, absolutely. I would say truth bomb time. Don't fake it till you make it. Work hard,
yeah.
do the research, be humble,
yeah.
Be respectful,
yeah.
Be intentional.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, understand that life is a marathon. It will have its ups and downs, peaks and valleys,
yeah, that's good.
And every storm will pass, right?
Yeah.
And just because you got to the top of the mountain, everyone, just because you got to the top of the mountain doesn't mean that like you won't go down one day.
That's right.
So you need to yeah. be humble in your journey. Appreciate every single moment you have. Appreciate all the people that you meet in your life. Take it one step at a time. And remember this, for all of you that are trying to rush the process out there, I know everybody's out there looking for a secret hack, a shortcut. Mm-hmm. Look at this. If you know what your goals are, you know what your purpose is.
Mm-hmm.
You do one thing a day for a year, just a year. Let's just say that, which is like a blink of an eye. You have 365 opportunities to get it right and get it wrong.
That's right.
And even take a day off.
Yeah, that's awesome. CJ, thank you so much. Y'all, I'm so excited that we had this time together. And wow, everything. I mean, we just, mental health, keeping it real. Don't fake it till you make it. Be authentic. Be your own brand. Have a level of responsibility. Have a level of discipline. And just allow yourself to be secure with being insecure sometimes. Like sometimes, you know, we're a little insecure out there publishing stuff, but knowing that that's just humanity. You know, that's just how we're made and we're okay with that. And just pushing along the way and living a purpose-led life. And that's great. That all ladders up to being your best brand on social media and having the best impact you can make.
Great.
All right, buddy. All right, y'all. We'll see you next time. Thanks for hanging in. We're out.